In the world of natural testosterone boosters, few supplements are as regarded as highly as d-aspartic acid. So, does d-aspartic acid really raise testosterone levels? Let's look at the proof. So, here we have a 12-day long investigation involving 23 men from an in vitro fertilization clinic who were given a supplement called Datavit that contained d-aspartic acid, plus vitamins B6, B12, and folic acid. More specifically, they consumed about 10 milliliters, roughly 0.3 ounces of a liquid solution that contained 3.12 grams of d-aspartic acid. These researchers reported that after 12 days, the d-aspartic acid dietary supplement improved both testosterone and luteinizing hormone. Luteinizing hormone is one of the hormones that you need to make testosterone. But how much were the testosterone levels increased? Turns out, by a whopping 42%. Furthermore, these researchers also reported that while testosterone levels dropped a little bit 3 days later, their levels were still elevated, more than baseline, at least 3 days later after the guys stopped taking the dietary supplement. So from this investigation, d-aspartic acid would tend to be a win. But we're not done yet. In this investigation, the same supplement called Datavit was tested again in this study of 30 infertile men with slow swimming sperm. Here, a 90-day treatment with 2.66 grams of d-aspartic acid led to an increase in sperm and the swimming ability of the sperm. Now that's nice, and it was also reported that there was an increase in the number of pregnancies, about 27%, in those who were taking the d-aspartic acid dietary supplement, revealing that perhaps this dietary supplement may help couples with conception. But what about testosterone levels? Well, it was reported that both testosterone and, again, luteinizing hormone did increase after taking this dietary supplement between 1.3 and 1.6 times higher than their normal levels. So pretty interesting, but let's remember that these guys were infertile. So what else we got? In this investigation, 19 young and middle-aged men who were accustomed to the rigors of strength training were given a placebo or 6 grams, 6,000 milligrams of d-aspartic acid for 3 months, in addition to a 4-day-a-week weightlifting program. So did d-aspartic acid work this time? No. Results show that d-aspartic acid did not raise total testosterone or free testosterone levels. But we're not done yet. Let's move on. The title of this study pretty much says it all, but regardless, here we have 16 mountain climbers who are given 3 grams, 3,000 milligrams, of d-aspartic acid or a placebo for 2 weeks while the men continued with their normal workout routines. Here it was reported that, again, d-aspartic acid at a dosage of 3,000 milligrams did not raise either testosterone levels or luteinizing hormone levels, and it also didn't improve athletic performance either. And then we have this investigation of 20 young guys in their 20s, probably college students, who were given 3 grams, 3,000 milligrams, of d-aspartic acid or a placebo for 28 days in conjunction with a 4-day-a-week weightlifting program. As the title of the study spells it out for us, 3 grams of d-aspartic acid did not raise testosterone levels, and it also did not improve muscle strength or muscle mass either. So let's try to make some sense out of all this. Here's a summary of the studies just presented. As you can see, the results don't seem to make sense at first. For example, how did 3.12 grams and 2.66 grams of d-aspartic acid raise testosterone, and in one case do it significantly after just 12 days, but in other investigations, greater dosages of d-aspartic acid did not work? Well, one explanation could be the participants recruited for the investigations. Recall that in both the 2009 and the 2012 studies, the participants were men who appeared to have fertility problems. In the 2009 study, they actually say they got their volunteers from an in vitro fertilization clinic. In that investigation and in the follow-up study that occurred in 2012, d-aspartic acid appeared to work. However, if we look at the other studies, which involve essentially healthy people who have no apparent health problems, D-aspartic acid did not raise testosterone levels. So after reading all these studies on D-aspartic acid and testosterone, I personally don't think it's a viable method to raise testosterone levels in healthy men, although I think maybe we could leave the door open in those who may have some fertility problems. I also think that some of the studies have quality problems too, so I do think we need better investigations to get a better handle on all this. However, what do you think? Have you tried D-aspartic acid to naturally raise your testosterone levels? Leave a comment below and let me know what happened. Until next time, I'm Joe from SupplementClarity.com. Take care.